In this course, we're using WebGL and a developer's library I chose called three.js. WebGL is an application program interface, API for short, that controls the GPU. It is based on OpenGL-ES, an API used in mobile devices, which in turn is based on OpenGL, an API for desktop computers that dates back to 1992. The other major competing API is called DirectX or Direct3D, which is commonly used for games on the Xbox console and Windows PCs. This is almost the last time I'll mention DirectX. It's not all that different from WebGL. In fact, Google Chrome on the PC turns WebGL commands into DirectX calls. See additional course materials for more information. WebGL itself is a state-based API. You set up exactly how you want the GPU to do something, then send a geometry to render under these conditions. This gives a pretty fine-grained control over the GPU, but can result in hundreds of lines of code to draw even the simplest scenes. This is why we'll be using three.js, a free development library with many useful features. Just a few lines of code in three.js can create objects with materials, set up lighting in a camera, and even perform animation.